Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. I wanted to talk about rounding whole numbers in this video. Often it's beneficial to estimate or round a number. We can round a number to any place value, but when we do, we look to the place value to the right of the number we want to round to. That's a little confusing to say, but we're going to look at this. If we want to round to the tens place, we would look at the ones place because that would be directly to the right of where we want to go. Rounding to the thousands, we look at the hundreds place, and so forth. So let's take a look at what that looks like. If I want to round to the tens place, I look at the number in the ones place. That's one to the right. If I want to round to the thousands, I look at the number in the hundreds place. That's one to the right. If I want to round to the hundreds, I look at the tens place. If I want to round to the thousands, then I look to the thousands place. So I'm always looking one to the right of where I actually want to round. That's an important fact to remember. Okay, and here's how we decide if we're going to round. If the number to the right, we're looking at the numbers where the arrows are, if that number to the right is less than 5, that is if it's 4, 3, 2, 1, or 0, do not change the number to which you are rounding. If the number to the right is 5 or more, that is 5, 6, 7, 8, or 9, add one number to the number to which you are rounding. In either instance, the remaining numbers or the trailing numbers should be 0. All right, so let's do those problems from up above. If I want to round 4,531 to the tens place, then I am looking at the ones place, and that number is less than 5. So that means I don't change my 10, I would have 4,530. Notice that anything after the number we round to is going to become a 0. If I want to round 29,745 to the hundreds, to the thousands place, I'm looking at this number. And this is a little tricky because it's 7, which means we're going to add 1 to 9, but we can't write 10 there. If I add 1 to 9, that's going to make 10, and I'm going to have to carry that number, that 0 is going to go, but then the 1 is going to carry to the next number. Sorry, I said that really confusingly. So I'm going to get 30,000. So the 29 bumps up to 30 because I can't put two digits in that one place. I have to make that one add on to two places to make that work. So even though we were trying to round here, it looks like we rounded to the 10,000s, but we did not. We don't round it to the thousands. Okay, what about this one where we're going to round to the hundreds and we're looking at the number to the right? Again, this 9 is in the second category here. That is, it's more than 5, so we're going to round this number 4. We're going to add 1 to that and make that 5. Anything before that stays the same, and anything after that becomes a 0. As always, it's good to shut it off and try these on your own, see how you do. And then let's look at going to the 10,000s. We're looking then, the one around here, we're looking one to the right. And in this case, 3 is less than 5. So we know we're not going to change this 2. We're going to keep that the same. We don't ever go down. We either stay the same or add 1. So now we're going to get 1, 2, and then everything else that trailed that becomes a 0. Okay, then let's look at dollars. You can be given dollars, and later when we do decimals, you'll be given decimals and asked to round to cents. But this one just says round $45,398 to the nearest hundreds. Well, that means we're going to round here to the hundreds. And that, I shouldn't use that. I should use a different notation all of a sudden. We're going to round to the hundreds, but we're going to look to the right. And since that number is more than 5, we're going to add 1 to the place we're rounding. So we get 45,400. That is rounding that number to the nearest hundreds. And finally, or two more, round the numbers to the thousands, then find the sum. That is, we're not rounding at the end of the problem, we're rounding at the beginning. So we're going to round this to the thousands, and like what happened before, I'm doing this again, We are looking to the right, which this number is 5, so that means we're going to go and add 1. But we can't add 1 to 9 without getting a 0 there, so we're going to add it to 49 and get 50. So we have 50,000. Now this is a sum, which means we're going to add. And then here, when we round this one to the thousands, we're rounding here, we're looking here, and this 4 is less than 5, so we're not going to change anything here, and that's going to be 54,000. And now that we've rounded them both to the thousands, we find the sum by just adding those up. We get 104,000. And finally, we have round to the hundreds, then find the difference. A difference is a subtraction problem, right? So we're going to subtract these. We're going to round to the hundreds. The hundreds is right here, so we're going to be looking at the numbers in the tens place. Well, when I look one to the right here, that is greater than 5, so that means that's going to go up to 1,700. This one, though, when I look one to the right, that's less than 5, so the 8's not going to change. That's going to be 800. And now I'm ready to subtract that. I have 0, 0. I need to borrow here. That's going to leave 0 there or nothing. And I'm going to have 17 minus 8, which is 9. So my answer is 9. In this case, we estimated first and then carried out the operations. All right, thanks, and have a great day.